Good afternoon. My name is Anna Gallis, and I'm the Director of Academic Leadership Initiatives here at the Western Interstate Commission for Higher Education. I'm going to talk to you today about Interstate Passport. This is the first of four-part series on becoming a member of the Interstate Passport Network. I encourage you to visit our website and view the remaining presentations. As a result of the coronavirus's impact on higher education and the economy, in July of 2020, we issued a call to action to help fix transfer for students nationwide. Thousands upon thousands of students are expected to stop out, drop out, or transfer in the coming months and beyond. Many of these students will be crossing state lines. These students need our help, and they need it now. Interstate Passport is a national program that enables the block transfer of lower division general education based on student learning outcomes rather than specific courses or credits. It was developed based on four guiding principles. First and foremost, that it is focused on students. Second, that it is driven by faculty, but allows for institutional autonomy and has built-in quality assurance. Data from the National Student Clearinghouse shows that 38% of the 2.8 million students that started the 2011 academic year transferred at least once during a six-year period. Over 27% of those students actually crossed state lines. It's important to note that states are doing good work improving transfer within their borders, but students that are crossing state lines are often being left behind. There are multiple barriers to the transfer process, chief among them being the loss of credits. According to the U.S. Government Accountability Office, students on average lose 43% of their credits upon transfer. This unnecessarily burdens students where they have to spend more time and money repeating courses as they pursue their educational goals. Interstate Passport grew out of the need to better serve transfer students, and it was identified by two membership organizations, the Western Alliance of Community College Academic Leaders and the Western Academic Leadership Forum. These organizations are housed at WICHE, one of four regional compacts that and serves 2 and 4 year member institutions in the Western states. All students who complete the courses identified in an institution's block with a grade C or better earn a passport, not just students intending to transfer. Students are recognized for their learning that they have achieved, and this is noted on their transcript. A passport can be considered a milestone of completion along the way to a degree. Students who earn a passport know that they have fulfilled the lower division general education requirements at a network member institution and will not have to repeat courses upon transfer, again, saving them time and money. Earning a passport may also have value in the workforce, as it demonstrates that students have learned meaningful foundational skills. In the first 3 years of full operation and implementation, Interstate Passport Network member institutions have awarded over 38,800 passports. Data for the 2019-20 academic year is currently being submitted by institutions to the National Student Clearinghouse. The passport learning outcomes were developed by teams of faculty from both 2 and 4 year institutions spanning 7 different states across the country. Faculty identified 63 learning outcomes that cover 9 knowledge and skill areas. And passport learning outcomes also align with the AACNU LEAP Essential Learning Outcomes. When mapping outcomes, faculty determine, the alignment of student learning outcomes to passport learning outcomes, and often find that the courses achieving the passport learning outcomes may be identical to the general education courses and requirements. Many states and or institutions have learning outcomes which have already been mapped to general education courses. So simply put, faculty are mapping student learning outcomes to passport learning outcomes to ensure that they cover the same range of learning. Once congruency of the passport learning outcomes has been determined, faculty identify the courses that fulfill the learning outcomes. This slide shows a side-by-side comparison at a large and small institution. As you can see, the course selection will vary as students are working to achieve those learning outcomes. Typically, a passport block will range from 30 semester credits to 38 and 45 quarter credits to 60. You can view network member institutions passport blocks on our website. So what are the benefits to institutions? Interstate Passport is a tool that can simplify the transfer process. No direct course-by-course articulation comparison is needed for lower division general education. Ongoing management of numerous articulation agreements as well. It can also be used as a recruitment tool and to facilitate increased retention. It allows for curriculum flexibility at any time. Institutions also receive academic tracking data post-transfer for continuous improvement processes on their campuses. Quality assurance measures have been incorporated into the program since its inception. The passport learning outcomes, again, were developed by faculty teams and are monitored on an annual basis. Students must earn a minimum of a C or better in each course that makes up a passport block. Academic progress tracking data post-transfer is submitted to the National Student Clearinghouse. The Passport Review Board, which is the policy-making program, reviews the overall effectiveness of the program and does continuing monitoring. Currently, there is an independent evaluation of the program being implemented by the Education and Employment Research Center at Rutgers University. Early data on Interstate Passport is yielding positive results. For the 2018-19 academic year, students who transferred with a passport had significantly higher GPA as compared to those who transferred without a passport. In addition, those students who transferred with a passport also enrolled in, on average, in a higher number of credits per semester as compared to those who transferred without a passport. Students are tracked for at least two terms post-transfer. Data is broken down or broken out by age, gender, race, ethnicity, Pell eligibility, veteran status, first generation, and more. This data can be used to identify strategies that may be helpful to increase student success. A full analysis of the academic progress tracking data can be found in our annual report on the Interstate Passport website. Interstate Passport is working to scale its membership nationally. Currently, there are 60 member institutions spanning 17 states. Four of those states have system-wide membership at this time. Membership fees are based on IPED's data for the number of full-time equivalent students reported during the prior academic year. Those fees range from $2,500 to $7,500 annually. Several discount options are available. Increased revenue from new and retained students may also offset the cost of membership fees. Institutions joining the network need to complete the following steps. First, identifying an institutional liaison, that is the person that will lead the efforts on the campus. Second, determining congruency of the student learning outcomes to the passport learning outcomes. If there is alignment, moving forward with the signature of a memorandum of agreement for membership in the network. Then working with faculty to identify the courses that will fulfill the passport block. Once the passport block is complete, that information will be uploaded, creating an Interstate Passport member profile on our site. Finally, implementing the programming to the student information system to award passports and track academic progress for reporting to the National Student Clearinghouse. What are our members saying about Interstate Passport? R. Joe Farrell noted that the Interstate Passport facilitates shared general education competencies across institutions of higher education. Francisco Rodriguez states that now is the time to fix transfer. Belle Whelan notes the Interstate Passport is a wonderful way for colleges across the country to feel confident that students have actually mastered the skills they need to be successful. And finally, George Mahaffey states that Interstate Passport reminds us of all of the real value of general education. Thank you, and we appreciate your time to learn more about Interstate Passport. If you have additional questions, please visit our website or email us at interstatepassport.edu.